a very good evening and welcome back to the show. Now to another story that has been making headlines, and of course it has been a point of concern for the student community especially, is of course the fee structure. Now in a move that is likely to ruffle a few feathers, the State Association for Nursery and Primary Schools today announced that if the Ravi Rajapandian Committee does not reveal its fee structure by May 10th, they will go ahead and go ahead with their own fee structure. Well, of course, to dwell on this one question, we have with us Dr. N. Vijayan. He's the General Secretary of Federation of Matriculation Schools Association of Tamil Nadu. So welcome to the show here. Great having you here today. Discussion on a very pertinent subject about school fees. Now, it has been in the limelight over the past few months. And parents have raised voices about the fact that this fee, we need a fee structure which is affordable. Now, affordability is the key word here. Let's first take up your side of the story about post May 10th, if talking about that permutation here, if the Ravi Rajapandian Committee does not come out with its recommendations, what is the road forward for the schools in Tamil Nadu?
In fact, the question of if doesn't come, because Honorable Court has given very clear verdict that they have fixed the timing. Within the timing, the committee has to really bring out the fee structure for the schools to collect. Academic year is going to start. Hardly a month to go. Right. I think we all really expect honestly that the committee will definitely fix the fees by then. Right. So therefore, there is no question of not fixing the fees.
So legally speaking, you feel that there is no alternative way but to actually go ahead with your own fee structure.
Right.
But let's. But what that basically means for parents is that obviously they might have to shell out a little bit more. So let's talk about this point of conflict here. We've had parents come in and express concern regarding school fees. How do you address those concerns? How do you address such criticisms that are fired at you, saying that schools are overcharging?
I'm sorry. In fact, this is a hype created by the media. See, if you just see cross section, the parents of the state. Hardly 10% of the parents, you know, just raised the issue of excess fees charged by certain schools. Mm-hmm. 90% of the parents are on their own. They are very happy for the type of quality education they receive. They feel this is the best investment of all the investment to get quality education, no matter how much you pay. But right. Schools are reasonable. As I agree, 10% of the schools have definitely gone slightly more than the limit. They exceeded the limit. But those schools should have been checked into in the beginning. But that is all over now. So now, it's definitely not an industry, it's not a business.
Right.
Every school has got a lot of requirements, demands to provide quality education, that too in view of Samichirkali, introduction of Samichirkali for their survival.
Sir, you're quoting some interesting statistics there. You claim that yes, the majority of the parents don't mind paying this extra amount of money. But we have been talking to a lot of parents and they backed the concept of perhaps a fee structure which is capped and which does not put too much pressure on their pockets. Do you think it's a reasonable demand by the parents, because it does hit the pockets as well? And more than that, more than hitting the pockets, it hits the inclusion factor. That's the claim by the parents and the activists, that education which should be spread out, which should include all the masses, all the children, that is one factor that gets hit. How do you address this criticism?
Actually, this is a group of vested interests, anti-social elements, I would rather say. This matriculation school concept is really mainly to cater the needs of education for the masses. We have been really doing this service. A group of people against matriculation schools only raised the issue in the form of parents as well.
Right.
So as I said, I'm telling you, because I'm being the general secretary of all the schools in Tamil Nadu, 90% of the parents are happy with the type of education they get. For the money they pay, they get the due for it. They are very happy. After all, we construct the future for the children.
Right.
And we have lot many other expenditures now. It has come since Justice Govindarajan Committee's decision came out. Like now we are asked to pay 6th pay commission, we have to pay gratuity, we have to pay ESA and so on and so forth. So many new regulations, government acts have come out. And how to address
these issues? Saying that for your proposition of a school to be commercially viable, it is important to, for the schools to be allowed to decide on their own fee structure. Is that what you're saying?
See, I don't say there needs to be some regulation. I definitely vouch the government act of regulation. But then this is not the way, because each school is unique in its own way.
Mm-hmm.
So supposing now with the introduction of e-learning, smart classes, which may not be there in a school in the neighborhood, but a particular school close by will have, we cannot have the same fee structure for these schools.
Right.
So, and plus, now the cost, as I said, 6th pay commission, the salary hike is 3 times.
Mm-hmm.
So if the fee is fixed based on the details that we have given earlier on, it will definitely, we will not be able to run the school.
Right.
And no parent is ever compelled that you have to admit your child, you have to ensure that education is given in this school. All the schools in the close by, government school, aided schools, they are providing quality education. Parents, it's open to parents to go any school. Why stick around in a particular school where they feel it is more and creating you and cry? I don't understand.
Right. So let's also talk about another common criticism. It's of course been the fact that school education, which was ideally seen as in, which has been recorded in Indian mythology as a philanthropic act and not so much of a commercial act, it is translating into the world of business now. Now, how do you address that need that here we have a very, very problem of acute shortage of good schools across the state and across the country, and here we have some schools which offer the quality, but then again offer a price tag which is beyond the capacity of your lower middle class people?
You are rightly said. Actually, matriculation school is unique in Tamil Nadu. No other state in India has. In fact, it was originally meant for the, as I said, for the parents of, children of elite category. But now, with this, you know, the race issued by the parents, I don't agree. As I said, if parent is not happy in the school, go to a school in the neighborhood.
But so you the can common go. Criticism is that most other schools don't have that quality. The government schools don't really match up to the quality that that a private school might offer with its better infrastructure, better faculty. So do you think that charging this premium over quality is warranted, is legitimate?
Actually, what you say is what was in 10 years back now, more than 10,000 odd crores have been spent for school education itself. Mm-hmm. Infrastructure and superstructure facilities available in government school, aided schools are really classic, really very good. We cannot just compare what it was then. Now it is really the best. Parents can really look out in case they are not able to afford it, as you said, affordability. It is really open. They also have English medium sections, say Samachir Kalvi, same pattern of education now from coming academic year. Why not?
Right. Final question, sir. We're running out of time here. Now, one question which is to which the matriculation, the Federation of Matriculation didn't quite come out very clearly, was they said that they will come out with their own fee structure. Now, what kind of jump are we looking at in terms of, if you were to talk about it in terms of numbers, how dearly will it hit, how dearly will it impact some of the parents looking to send their children?
We all, fervently hope that the committee by then will fix the fees. Otherwise, we have to go in by, the 2009-10 fees fixed by the, court.
Right, Mr. N. Vijayan, it was lovely having you here and having the school's perspective as well about what their position is in terms of hiking the fee rates as they proposed. Post May 10, that is, if Ravi Rajapandian committee does not come out with its numbers. Welcome to the show. Thank you so much, sir. It was lovely having you this time.
Welcome.
Let's move ahead now onto another some national pressing issues at that regarding corruption this time. Now, Karnataka Lokayukta Santosh Hegde will meet Anna Hazare in Delhi and other members of the civil society representatives on the drafting committee and then take a decision on whether to quit the Lokpal panel. Now, stung by the Congress leader Digvijay Singh's comments questioning his effectiveness, Hegde had threatened to resign. Hegde also said that the Congress leader's statements must be a part of a conspiracy to defame the people who are a part of that committee. Now, Anna Hazare, as we speak, is in the capital. In fact, a meeting of Lokpal civil representatives is being conducted. Now, the meeting comes after Karnataka Lokayukta Santosh Hegde said that he will decide if he wants to continue to be a part of the Lokpal committee.
आज मीटिंग है मीटिंग करके आ
जाए सर बाबा मीटिंग में क्या
बोल रहे थे वो रिजाइन करेंगे
मीटिंग में अभी देखेंगे क्या विषय है
अन्ना हेगड़े साहब बोल रहे थे कि वो रिजाइन करेंगे
आज फैसला हो जाएगा
एक एक दलित कार्यकर्ता हमारे ऐसा का तो मानना है तो क्या तुम्हारे
ऐसा इसके बारे में मैं नहीं बोलता हूँ
अन्ना आपको लगता है जनता के विश्वास को थोड़ी ठेस पहुँचे इन सब समस्याओं के
कोई ठेस नहीं पहुँची नहीं तो इतना भीड़ नहीं होना था
डेलीबरेटली क्या रही है
अगर ठेस पहुंचती तो मेरे पीछे इतने भीड़ नहीं होना था
एंड मूविंग अहेड MTV रोडी इज द फेमस रियलिटी शो टेलीविजन Hosts were attacked by ABVP activists in Pune. The incident happened when the hosts of the popular reality show were promoting it in the student city. Now, activists from ABVP blackened their faces to protest derogatory language being used by the anchors in the show.
The moral police strike in Sarasbagh, the heart of Pune, on Friday. Activists from the Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad waylaid anchors of the popular reality show MTV Roadies and blackened their faces, claiming the show used derogatory language. The Roadies were participating in a promotional rally in the city. The ABVP has issued a statement saying we will not tolerate derogatory language and humiliation of women in TV shows. The show's anchors have not registered a police complaint, choosing instead to issue a statement. Anchor Raghuram said, I have never defended or tried to justify myself to anybody and I don't plan on starting now. This is regular in the life of public figures and political parties looking for publicity. The question now is whether the police and state government will crack down on this very public display of cultural censorship, something that rears its head in Maharashtra all too often. With Imtiaz Jalil in Pune, Beverly White in Mumbai for NDTV.
Well, that's all we have time for in this bulletin. We'll of course be coming back in only a few minutes to give you more news and updates in Tamil. Keep watching NDTV Hindu.